phenomenal play on Farah, of all things. He's been playing great. They need everyone to play a little better around him has been the issue. And one shot got away with kind of some mistakes there, but it was enough. They set a good enough time, really. Their offense was good enough that it was not that big of a deal. So I think we're waiting for Rolf, who may have be...
I think he went to the can. look, I'm just playing an envy right now. You gotta call people out when they go to the bathroom. I'm saying Rolf went to the can. But the question is, Hex, have you caught your first Pokemon yet?
No, I'm casting Overwatch. I'm going to. I'm gonna go.
I mean, you could
eat.
Yeah, during the break, you could have burned an incense and went for one in that time. You did not use your time efficiently, and now you are down at least one, if not two, Pokemon as a result. Think about it, Hex.
I don't even know what any of that means. I'm already in over my head in this Pokemon world. I don't even know what any of that means. I'm gonna walk and go get something to eat, and then maybe I'll catch a Pokemon.
Here's what's gonna happen. Hex is gonna catch a Mewtwo on the way to a Chicago eatery and be like, I don't even know what this is. Is this good? And everyone's just going to roll their eyes and be like, yeah, you know, just one of the most legendary Pokemon. Yeah, it's kind of good, Hex.
Oh, Mewtwo's good? All right.
Beginner's luck.
I'll look forward to a Mewtwo, I guess.
Did you just say Moo and not Mew?
Is it Mew? Oh, M-E-U? Mewtwo? Okay. I'll look forward to that then.
I'm done. Texas solo casting this last game. I can't take this. I'm out. I'm not actually. We're going in. It's going to be Hollywood. It is one shot now, looking to finish this out. And they're in prime position to do so. They looked good in the last map, and they might just need one more punch to knock out Splice.
Yeah, kind of fitting that we're on Hollywood for Splice's life. It is a map that they've had some success on, but not enough. I mean, similar enough to their Overwatch history thus far. So I think this team just needs a little bit more time. I say that a lot about rosters, but I know that they have the talent, right? They have the skill. They're able to really hang on King of the Hill maps, which is usually a good barometer of are we individually as good as the other individual players. They just need a little cohesion and working together as a team, I think. So on that defense for this Splice team, it is going to be Pure on the Symmetra. Papa Smurf will play the Reinhardt. Sickness on the defensive Roadhog. Flame is going to play the support of Lucio. Clockwork on the Reaper. And Cozen on the Mercy. So a lot of support here. They're going to really need Sickness and Clockwork to be chiming in on the damage. Maybe Pure will go crazy and do offensive Symmetra.
Alrighty, well, take a look here at the offenses they set up for the side of One Shot. It's going to be Xe here on the Zarya, Dot on McCree, Rolf on the Lucio, Sicari on Mercy, Chronic on Reinhardt, and Melta Weapon. Going to round things out here on the Pharah.
Okay, so Flame was just on Lucio to get that Symmetra out. He was toying with the Junkrat. He is on a 76 now. That makes a lot more sense as chat catches up to my Mewtwo. Petition to have Hex burned at the stake, I guess. I'm sorry, guys.
Honestly, it's entirely appropriate. You said Mewtwo. There's no coming back from that. Offenso coming in right now from the side, one shot, and Ultima Weapon getting right back onto the cafe, throwing rockets at it, sending 76 off. Two quick kills here from the offense. And they're just blitzing down this defensive Splice. Clockwork does get one kill, trying to keep his team in this, looking for Xe, gets booped back. A life-saving boop coming out from Rolf. And slowly but surely, this is going to be One Shot's point very quickly, Hex.
Yeah, there is absolutely nothing they can do about it. They do res. Sickness is in here trying to pull it back, but I think at this point, you just gotta bail. Clockwork came in, gave his life and ultimate charge. So did Sickness. Now that is 600 HP going into the bank of the offensive ultimates.
Well, there you have it. They're going to cap this and get things going in a hurry. This is just an absolutely brutal pace being set right now by One Shot. They were not phased at all by the Splice defense. And for Splice, this is good. I mean, at the very least, they'll be able to set up here on the rooftops, but they don't even have ults for this next fight right now, Hex.
No, they're in a really rough position. You cannot lose first point like that. And you especially can't just give him another 850 HP of damage free for their ultimate banks. They're completely set up. Now they're going to fight him on the ground, I guess. They jump in.
Playing on the ground. Ultima up and going over the top. Here comes the barrage. Combos with the Graviton. Does take out Flame. Only gets that. We'll have expected a little bit more. But still, it's two kills here for One Shot. They're keeping momentum going. There's still two people on the payload. this is not a great look right now for Splice. They clearly do not have control of this game right now.
No, and if you look at just the coordination coming up in one shot, that's where they've improved the most. Ultima came up over the top in what is a really bad position and idea for the Pharah there. But he gets the Zarya shield. They communicate it perfectly in chat because it doesn't last that long. He's able to survive through gravity or through the barrage. He had no business doing this Earth Shatter.
Earth Shatter after the flashbang. This is just brutal right now coming out. Three kills coming out from the side of one shot. They are piling on right now. It's high noon. The Earth Shatter from the defense does absolutely nothing as Dot picks up the double kill. And I gotta say, Splice feels like it's falling apart right now.
Clockwork doing
even though
his best.
Clockwork trying to make a statement, trying to put the team on his back, and he might have given themselves an opening right as I said that. He was able to get the triple kill over the top. Papa Smurf coming into the fight. Let's turn around. Groton coming out again here in favor of the offense. Barrage over the top. Ultima up and saying hello. Taking out two. Gets Helix down in the end, but I don't know right now. One shot, it feels like they've been bullying Splice for most of this game.
Yeah, I mean, they stayed in here long enough to keep this fight going. This is a super long fight, as Exe was just in there on his Zarya forever. They do get pushed back finally, though, even as reinforcements did arrive. Exe does finally die. Their Splice is stabilized now. They've finally gotten a little bit of room here, mostly because of that 3k that Clockwork pulled off from his barrage that really he had no business trying to pull off, but got the 3 kills out of it.
Spam right now coming in from Ultima, and he has to be careful not to get picked off right now. He feels a little bit invincible, but 76 poke plus a rocket, that could spell goodnight to him if he's not careful. Offensive one shot coming back in, and this has been a good effort on Splice to buy some time. It was looking incredibly bad, but really off of that triple barrage from Clockwork, they were able to hang in there at least for a little bit longer. They're rushing in though, offense on the way, getting into that defense of Splice. Clockwork will go down. And here's the key here, will Kozen be able to get the res? Three kills though, four now coming out from the side.
Heroes never die.
Sakari brings Splice back. And res coming in, and this is, they're able to hold it.
Yeah, Sakari brought them back, but Ultima down again. Chronic goes down yet again. I like the switch from Exe to come onto this Winston, try to take this second roof, maybe deal a little bit with Clockwork, who's been above the team the entire time. But yeah, it's a full reset, decent hold there from Splice. They're actually going to hold rooftop now.
Splice has completely reestablished themselves. They were getting completely destroyed in the beginning of this game, sort of just bullied all throughout the rooftop phase, but Clockwork was a difference maker. He had that one moment where he had the triple barrage, the rest of his team came in right after, and ever since then, the flow of the game has changed. It has been much more in favor of Splice, and they've bought themselves a whole boatload of valuable time. Now look at the offense. They went through the building. Clockwork, though, is going to be able to come over the top. Will Justice rain from above? Sound Barrier on the way. He's going to hold it for at least a moment. Double Sound Barrier now coming out from the defense in turn. Everyone's feeling the beat. Is Flame able to get to the back? Takes out Wolf. I don't know about this approach right now from one shot. It's not working the least.
No, I don't really like going through that room. They know exactly where you are, and they're just hanging out above you. You're already putting himself at a disadvantageous position. Clockwork takes down Exe late. Exe switched heroes like the last three lives. We'll see if he switches yet again. And then Chronic is just completely segmented out.
I don't know. Well, I guess at that point, you just have to hope for death. Like, Chronic's just saying they're holding up the shield. At that point, why even hold up the shield? Just accept what's coming at that point. I don't know.
Well, buys a little time for Sakari to get the ult up, and she does res everyone. This fight is going to continue. Clockwork takes down Sakari, punishes them for bringing her up. Clockwork gets taken out. It is a brawl down on this cart now.
Oh, Hammer comes down, though. Chronic knocking down two. Is able to take out Sickness. Fight turning a little bit more even off of that res from Sakari, but see how this works. The defensive Splice still hanging in there. They're able to take out Chronic, and they still have better positioning right now as the Clockwork just chasing down the survivors with the Lucio speed boost.
Yeah, right now, one shot grasping at straws here. Exe is on that 76. They are going to move Dot over to Widowmaker, although Dot was playing really well on that Roadhog. I thought that was a better answer to Clockwork than this Widow, but it remains to be seen what he'll be able to get done. Ultima is on this Reaper. It's going to have Death Blossom up. Really, it's about their last good push in coming here. We need Dot to get something done early. Clockwork goes down to that Tac Visor. That's huge for them.
Yep, Exe able to take down Clockwork. Three kills here from the side of one shot. This might be what they need finally. Yeah. They're starting to turn things in their favor, and because Kozen's picked off, there won't be a life-saving res. So this is the best thing they've had for a while, but Flame versus Exe right now in the back. Almost taking out Exe, and you still see the defense fighting Splice, not wanting to give this up, but at this point, they might want to back up. It does look like We're going to have all the momentum we need from one shot. They should be able to get this point, and the fight for last should be beginning in just a moment.
They're still on this. They're all over.
I don't know about this. They rezzed towards him, they had the sound barrier, but can they really fight this back? I mean, they're buying some time here, but it could come at the cost of their defense for the final point.
Yeah, it's kind of something that Splice has been doing, though. They really don't want giving up points if they feel they don't have to. They did it on first point as well, fed into it there. Now they're just doing it again. That res is not going to be up if the push continues at this rate. Dot is almost going to have his infrared side up, which is going to lead to some huge pick opportunities. Aww.
I mean, why get infrasight when you can just hook people in? And actually, it looks like Ultimate Weapon is switching too, probably to a Pharah, if I had to guess.
Oh, Widow's so good at
this
last
point. No,
Genji,
okay.
Yeah, Ultima's a really good Genji. It's one of his favorite heroes. So they do charge in. Chronic completely out of position, gets countercharged. Not the best Reinhardt, but it's his first mistake of the night, really. I'll give him that one.
Still one down here for the offense, and one shot doesn't have a lot of time. His clockwork landing a gem of a rocket from long range takes out Ultimate Weapon. Now that death is going to get staggered. Really, there's only one more team fight left here for one shot. This has been a phenomenal comeback by Splice, where really it looked like they were dead in the water as this game began.
Yeah, it was a terrible first point, and even most of the second point until they were able to stabilize. TacVisor is going to have to get a lot of value here, and Sakari has to stay alive. It's the only way they finish out this map.
Defense right now is pushing the issue. Winston going deep in. Sickness with the TAC visor in the back, looking for Wolf. Wolf skated too close to the sky, ends up going down, but look at this straight about. They're going to be in. Chronic with a big Earth Shatter as Ultimate Weapon and Dot really deal with the Russian with absolute authority. And oh my goodness, that could not have gone any worse for Splice towards the end.
No, not at all. They're going to have to be, they're going to lock this out. Wow.
That. That's something.
Well, they killed
Clockwork.
I'm
actually a little flabbergasted by that. That was just...
They killed Clockwork and Sakari remained alive. So alive that she didn't even have to use her res. That's how alive.
And they got an early pick on that too. I think they went a little bit too deep. They thought they had too much of an advantage, and really Dot was able to rein it in, got a hook kill in the very beginning, and they just sort of snowballed from there, and Chronic came in a hurry with an absolutely monstrous Earth Shatter. So yeah, I don't know. That was a little bit weird on Splice's part, but one thing that they do have in their hip pocket is that they did defend for quite a while. This is a very defensible time, and if their offense is remotely decent, they should be able to match this.
Well, to stay alive in the tournament, Splice has to do something that I've never seen them do. And maybe I'm being wrong, maybe I'm being exaggerating. I don't think so. I can't recall it, but I do watch a lot of Overwatch, so I forget some games. They're going to have to capture Hollywood second, and then last. I've yet to see them finish out Hollywood. So we'll see. They have to do it to stay alive, and they have to do it in a time of 8:28.
Indeed, and 8:28, so, I mean, again, it's pretty beatable, but... The one thing that's going to be rough, and we've seen teams get stuck a lot here today, I think the biggest factor will be, can they get through point A in a hurry? Certainly, one shot was able to do that, but you can't always count on that. So we'll have to see. A big part here will, of course, be Exe versus Clockwork. Exe is probably going to take up residence here in the cafe. This is the cafe. Pharah's coming over the top. They shoot rockets into it. They try and take out the 76. It's a very key part of this matchup, but looking at the defense as they are set up, Sakari is going to be on the Mercy. Wolf on Symmetra. Ultimate Weapon on Junkrat. Exe on the 76. Chronic on Reinhardt. And Dot going to round things out here on the Roadhog.
Yeah, Clockwork is going to be running Pharah yet again. He's going to take the skies with Kozen. Pure on the Winston is going to be the initiator here. It's going to be up to him to really bomb this cafe. Papa Smurf on the Reinhardt. Sickness on Soldier 76. Flame on Zarya. So they're going to probably try to shield and run this Winston right up over the cafe if they can. They're getting poked pretty hard down by these sentries right now. And yeah, that's a kill for Rolf as well.
That's a double penalty because that means the teleporter is going to be that much closer to actually coming up. Rolf actually, historically, even earlier in the day, has had problems getting his teleporter up particularly quickly. It takes him a while compared to those Symmetras. I'm not really sure why, but for Rolf, this is a much better start. Still, though, Ultimate Weapon goes down, and that's a big, big pick given what Ultimate Weapon has done for this defense. It's now 5v5, and the offensive Splice coming in from the left, setting up on the right. And a lot's going to depend on Exe here to just sort of defend this cafe and stop things from going badly. But Pure goes a little bit too deep, is immediately taken out. back and forth, and Splice still looking okay here, Hex.
If they can hold this just a little longer and let Rolf get back into this with his teleporters he was taking down early, but he does have 100%, they should be okay. Can Sakari get a res down? That is huge.
The res does come out. Oh no, ultimate weapon is back. Fire in the hole. Here comes the tire. It runs over three people. Ultima weapon, the savior. The res comes in immediately, so the offense is not out of it just yet. But what a tire coming in from ultimate weapon to give the defense a shot in the arm.
Teleporter comes up now too, so that's really good. They know the teleporter's up. They can't get in there to do anything about it because Chronic is up. Rolf is going just crazy now because he's done his job. Any bonus you get out of Symmetra now is just that, a bonus. Pure is going to use his ult.
Pure uses the ult. Teleporter is still up and in play. Has not been found just yet. Grounds on Sergio comes up from the offense. Pulls in Chronic. Chronic countering with the Earth Shatter. Knocks down two, but not quite getting what they want. However, you're still going to have people streaming in here from the teleporter, so the defense has a chance to keep contesting this, even though things are looking pretty darn good here for Splice. In
range of the objective. Yeah, they are going to get this. Splice is so confident. In fact, they're already moving forward. Pure is playing very aggressive, already takes first rooftop.
Ooh, Clockwork flew too close to the sun, gets taken up by Ultima Weapon. Ultima Weapon going to maintain control of the rooftops here for the defense, and the defense should be able to set up. They weren't completely wiped out right before the beginning of that.
Yeah, but a pretty good time there from Splice. Even with that teleporter up, they were able to deal with it. Now the question is, can Dot get enough work done on this Widow to justify it? Enough to make Splice at least switch up to something different. They are running a decent counter for it, of course. They have Pure. But if he has to bomb in all alone to try to deal with this Widow, it's going to be bad times. Dot takes down Flame.
Dot was able to pick off Flame early there. This is now 65 in favor of the defense. Ultimate Weapon coming in, knocking Papa Smurf into a very uncomfortable position. And for the defensive one-shot here, I mean, they do have to hold for quite a while. You look at the time that's left. They still have to hold for 5.5 minutes. So for them, they can't make any huge mistakes. If they lose the street space here in the next 2 or 3 pushes, the odds that they lose the game is so much higher. So they need to be disciplined. They need to make Splice actually earn this rather than giving away. And oh my goodness, Papa Smurf rejected, sends right off of that rooftop. As Dot has been feasting on Flame.
Yeah, he took down Flame yet again. Dot is going to stay alive here. It's a huge rattle on the cart. Resurrection comes in late, though. That Chronic has his Earth Shatter up, too. Could be a game changer. They don't really need it right now.
This has been really bloody. Clockwork was able to get to the top. He took out Dot, but the Tac Visor of XE doing work. Here comes Flame, the one last people into the fight, but still, Tracers can mess things up, but not when they take a rocket to the face.
Hard to be effective after that. Dot does have infrared sight up, so it's going to be really hard for the offense to push in without just be waiting for their Rein. They do actually switch up. Clockwork is now on his sniper, but yeah, you're going into a sniper battle with infrared sight on the opposing sniper. You're probably going to lose that. Dot takes him out.
Dot has been turning this game in one-shot's favor. The key thing here is that not only has been killing Flame on the Widowmaker, but he's also been causing the... Now he's causing the Widow of their own, and if Clockwork isn't able to win the Widow battle, it's double the penalty because now they just have a Widow that's dying on top of having to deal with the Widow. So Dot has been a huge difference maker in this game right now.
Yeah, I mean, just look how they have to initiate here. They have to move to the other side. They drop the Winston bubble already just so that they can get through here. Clockwork does take down Dot, though. Kozen dies on the other end.
The only downside there is that while he's doing that, Ultima Weapon just bombed in from the top, took out both. Earthshatter coming down from Chronic right now, setting up Sickness for failure. That's going to be 3 kills here for the side of One-Shot. And One-Shot, again, they're buying themselves the time they need to buy now. And even if they're in the loose streets phase now, they would still have an outside shot of holding.
Yeah, I mean, they're making a really good defense here. So much so they're holding this front roof. I think they should back off. You've had really good success holding second roof. There's no reason to really push forward and lose the angles that have been working so well for you already.
I gotta say, look at what Dot is doing to how Splice is setting up here. Their setups are much slower. They're all worried about getting picked off, so the Widow is making her presence known. That's the thing about Widow. Even when she's knocking kills, she still affects how you have to position because, you know, you might not respect 76 poke that much, but you certainly have to respect Widow poke because it can one-shot you. Here comes the offense. They're getting right on top of the rooftop, looking for an opportunity here, but the defense hanging in there, counter fire strike coming in, forcing Flame back. They're going to hold on this rooftop, but in comes Clockwork, takes out Ultima Weapon. 3 kills now for the Splice side as they're moving in. working on all levels right now. Ultimate Weapon, Papa Smurf even getting to building, getting a double kill. Down goes Krennic, and Papa Smurf finding the kills he needs to here on Winston. And now, 2 minutes, 55 seconds left here on the official timer. The in-game, the stopwatch, 2 minutes and a half. So lots of time here for Splice to turn this map in their favor and force a map three.
Yes, Akari dies yet again really late. They're bleeding out deaths here as they are two down already as the offense continues to push in. They're going to have Attack Visor and a Resurrection of their own as well. Clockwork's been doing a ton of work. This is one of the first points that we saw Widow really break into the game was offensive Hollywood last. It's just such a long sight line. Can't do much on the defense except just hide around corners left and right. They're going to have to try to go in through the top here, top left.
They're trying to go in. Xe's trying to deny it, but Papa Smurf again in the right place at the right time, able to stop Xe in the beginning. Xe now trying to make up for lost time, doesn't have Attack Visor, will gun flame down in this top building. And the defense finally stabilizing a little bit. And this is, again, it's on the margin right now for Splice. Things were looking good for them, but they only have a minute 30 left. So in reality, if they don't win this next fight, it's probably over. Clockwork, though, taking out Xe, making his case. Xe will be down, and they need to go in sooner rather than later here, Hex, before Xe is able to get back to this fight.
Yeah, it would bode well for them, but his reinforcements are so quick. I think he just wanted to be in a better position. Yeah, Flame is behind.
Showed him where he was. Able to take out Sakari. Xe with the immediate punish, but the Mercy is down. There will be no res here for the defense, and Splice making their case, moving in. And we'll take a look at Kozen. Kozen has a res. The res that the defense does not have will be resing up those fallen attackers, but Ultimate Weapon coming in with the Death Blossom takes out two. This is really close here in the point. The problem is that Sakari's going to be back in a minute, and she will have a res up. Defensive one shot, trying to hang in.
Sakari couldn't get out. Got killed again. Let's drop the beat. It's just Ultima.
She got the res up and didn't get a whole lot off of it. Now it's Ultimate Weapon versus the world. Flaming over the top. There's still 48 seconds remaining. And will one shot be able to delay enough? You can't do tons of D.Va and Tracer here. You can just have one D.Va, one Tracer. Wolf and Dot on the point. Here we go. 30 seconds remaining here. Do they what takes a big O shot from Krennic, knocks down three, smashes into sickness, swings the hammer. May is out right now, so they're pulling out everything in their bag of tricks to try and delay this just a little bit longer. And Hex, time-wise, it's so close, but there you have it. With only about, our timer is a little bit slow, it was about 10 seconds remaining. Splice going to stay alive.
Yeah, that was. I did about 5 seconds on my clock there too. So we're going to a map three to see who gets to stay in this tournament between One Shot and Splice. Splice finished Hollywood. Hooray! Splice.